Lighting is one of the most critical elements in creating immersive visuals, and Unreal Engine offers three powerful tools: ray tracing, lumen, and path tracing. But which one is right for your project? In this video, I'll break down the differences, explain how they work, and show you real-world examples to help you decide. Ray tracing simulates the behavior of light by tracing its path and interactions with surfaces. This allows us to achieve realistic shadows, reflections, and global illumination. It's especially useful for creating photorealistic visuals in games and cinematics. However, ray tracing requires powerful hardware like NVIDIA RTX GPUs to run smoothly. I will show you an example of how enabling ray tracing transforms a scene. So I opened abandoned apartment project from Megascans, and we're gonna see how ray tracing can change the scene just by enabling it. First step you have to do is go to Edit, open Project Settings, and in Rendering category, and here look for Global Illumination and set it to Standalone Ray Tracing, and same for Reflections. And leave Reflection Resolution to default, and make sure Hardware Ray Tracing is enabled under Hardware Ray Tracing section. And restart your project. I will choose a camera, and will enable Ray Tracing for that particular camera, and see what we can achieve with NVIDIA Ray Tracing. Now we can directly head to Details panel and search for Global Illumination, and from drop-down list select Standalone Ray Tracing. And now again search Ray in the search box, and we'll just enable Everything is required for our scene. Ray Tracing Global Illumination type in most cases should be brute force, but it takes a lot of load on your GPU. So try to leave values on default, or it may crash your project, or you can increase it little by little according to you. But don't go for high value. It'll definitely gonna crash after that. I set max bounces to 4. It means light will bounce 4 times on surface. And I set the samples at 8, so it'll calculate lighting 32 times before it shows us a final render of a scene. And they're more than enough in my opinion. You wondering why 32 times? Because bounces and samples multiply to get the final results, like anti-aliasing samples in movie render queue. I'm enabling reflections and setting value according to my scene, but ray tracing so heavy on my PC my OBS can't even record it, so I'll skip the frozen frames. Now we can enable ray tracing ambient occlusion. And difference is noticeable on viewport, and if you have water environment, feel free to enable refraction as well. Everything we needed for ray tracing is enabled, and it looks better than before. Let's enable it on another scenario and see the difference. I will fast forward the process. This is with ray tracing, and this is without ray tracing. One thing you may have noticed that when you try to enable ray tracing, it says standalone ray trace deprecated means it was replaced by Lumen. I will explain everything about it in my video once we finish learning the difference in all three tracing pipelines of rendering. Lumen is Unreal Engine's answer to real-time dynamic lighting. Unlike ray tracing, it doesn't rely on hardware-intensive calculations. Instead, it uses approximations to deliver impressive results in real time. With Lumen, lighting reacts dynamically to changes in the scene. This makes it ideal for games with open-world environments or projects that need to run on less powerful hardware. Let's move to the Unreal Engine and see how Lumen work on our same scene. For Lumen, we have to change Global Illumination and Reflection method inside Project Settings again. Once we change the Global Illumination to Lumen, reflections will be set to Lumen automatically. You just have click OK button when it asks you to. And also make sure use hardware ray tracing for Lumen is enabled, so Unreal Engine can use your NVIDIA RTX card to get better results. I leave software ray tracing mode to detail tracing and raise lighting mode on hit lighting for reflections. Unreal Engine may ask you to restart your project. Open sequencer and select camera and set global illumination method to Lumen. And then search for Lumen in Details panel, and enable everything you need for your scene. I usually enable everything except Diffuse Color Boost. And if you see any noise in your viewport or light flickers, set Final Gather Quality to 10. That's how you enable Lumen for inside your game or movie project. To explain it more accurately, I will use a simple objects and light to show you how real-time Lumen works. I already enabled Lumen for this scene. Now I will add a point light and see how it'll cast shadows and reflections on metallic sphere. Let me move the light on left side of that object, and as I move point light, the reflection and shadows updating on our viewport in real time. Reflection can be seen on that metallic sphere and also on the floor. And it's really accurate, like standalone ray tracing. Let's add spotlight and let's delete point light just to demonstrate how shadows work real time. I have to move it to the same location or any location you want on your scene. Again, it's just for demonstration of how accurate Lumen is. I will increase the intensity, and now shadows are more visible. To make your shadows and lights more accurate, go to Details panel of your spotlight and search for ray tracing and set it to enabled. It'll take few seconds to change it and set samples per pixel to value of 16. And now if you move your light, it'll cast shadows more accurately and also reflections, everything in real time. So if Lumen focuses on real-time performance, what about path tracing? Let's explore. Path tracing is the ultimate tool for achieving cinematic realism. It calculates lighting for every pixel, simulating light bounces for a stunningly accurate result. But this level of detail comes at a cost. This level of detail is fake. While this clip demonstrates incredible visual fidelity using mods that enhance ray tracing, it's important to clarify that this isn't true path tracing. Instead, it's a showcase of how modding can elevate Cyberpunk 2077's graphics to new heights. The reason I showed you this video so you don't feel demotivated if you can't achieve this type of visuals in Unreal Engine. And one thing about path tracing, it takes too much computation power to render the scene. That's it's suitable to render still images and cinematic scenes. Let's switch to Unreal Engine and see how we can enable path tracing in our project. First step we have to do is to make sure if path tracing and hardware ray tracing is enabled in project settings. Inside project settings, under rendering category, look for hardware ray tracing section and enable all of them. I won't enable texture LOD because LOD is not required in this project. Enable ray traced shadows as well. One enabled, close project settings and restart your project. And I'm opening same camera like last time. And now in viewport, change lit mode to path tracing. It takes some time to switch because path tracing takes 100% of your GPU to show you results. Since path tracing isn't real time, that's why it has so much noise in the scene, which means it's calculating lighting to achieve realism. Keep in mind that lighting we used for real ray tracing and Lumen won't look good in path tracing. Let's search path tracing in details panel of our camera. And I will enable everything, and I will leave max bounces and sample per pixel on default for now. And now it's time to play with the exposure to see how it affects the shadows. I will set exposure at 10, and then enable reference depth of field and reference atmosphere. These two settings actually help your scene to look better in most cases. And you can see an orange loading bar inside viewport. That bar indicates how long it'll take to load your path-traced scene. If you set sample per pixel to lower value, it'll load instantly, but still won't be in real time. And here are the lighting components you can select for path tracing to render. For example, if I disable any component from this list, it won't show inside viewport. I'll disable diffuse, and you can notice the difference. One tip for all fellow creators. Don't use denoiser for path tracing, instead increase the sample per pixel. I will set the sample per pixel to 7500, and since we chose pretty high value, it'll take minutes to render this simple scene, but without any noise and in high quality. It took 2 minutes 27 seconds to render this. The render duration depends on your machine. And while making this video, I realized there's one more rendering technique I need to add to this video. Now that we've covered ray tracing, lumen, and path tracing, let's talk about the rendering technique that started it all, rasterization. Rasterization has been the backbone of real-time rendering for decades. It works by converting 3D models into 2D images by projecting them onto the screen. Unlike ray tracing or path tracing, rasterization doesn't simulate light behavior. It approximates it, which is why it's extremely fast and efficient. What I mean by approximates it: rasterization approximates the light by using pre-calculated or baked lighting techniques instead of simulating the physical behavior of light rays. It determines how objects are lit based on simple calculations, like light direction and intensity, rather than tracing rays. But how does it work? Think of rasterization as a process that slices objects into triangles, determines which triangles are visible, and then colors them based on textures, shaders, and lighting. While it's not as realistic as ray tracing or path tracing, it's incredibly optimized for games and other real-time applications. Rasterization still dominates real-time rendering for one key reason: performance. It allows developers to achieve smooth gameplay even on mid-tier hardware by relying on baked lighting techniques and approximations. However, rasterization comes with limitations. For instance, reflections and shadows may not be physically accurate unless you use additional techniques like screen space reflections, SSR, or shadow maps. That's why hybrid techniques, like combining rasterization with ray tracing, are becoming popular to deliver the best of both worlds. For example, in The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, global illumination was baked into textures, meaning light bouncing is pre-rendered and doesn't adapt dynamically. Reflections, achieved using techniques like screen space reflections, SSR, which only reflect objects visible on the screen, leading to inaccuracies for off-screen objects. And the shadows, created using shadow maps, which are essentially 2D projections of shadows from the light source's perspective. Let me try to explain in different way. I don't know motion graphic, so I will explain the rasterization inside Blender. I will switch to Blender. I'm using plane for surface, and I will add a monkey mesh as our object. If you do modeling, you may know that models have quadrilateral topology, or simply a quad. But in game engines, we use triangulated polygons. For example, in edit mode, we have four vertices face on this model. If you're wondering why artists and creators use quads, the simple answer is quads are best for creating perfect topology and smooth and deformable surfaces, especially for animations or sculpting. They also provide better topology for subdivision, like in smoothing operations, compared to triangles. And when you import quad topology models inside Unreal Engine from Maya or Blender, Unreal Engine, it'll automatically convert all quads into triangles, so you don't have to worry about it while modeling. Time to add a light in our scene. So let's add a point light from add button. And I will move light on the top of our model. Since we're inside a shading mode, we can't see light in our scene, so we have to switch it to render view mode, and then you can see if the light affecting the object. But there are no shadows on the surface, because rasterization needs shadow maps to cast shadows. And for reflections, we have to use screen space. And if I move the light, it's updating in real time. For games, I told you game developers uses bake lighting technique. So they position the lights in the game environment and bake the lighting of the scene. And that's how they achieved beautiful looking environments, games like Dark Souls 3 and GTA 5. Sorry if video going too long, I just want you to know about rasterization. Because of this lighting technique, we can play competitive games like CSGO. It has smooth gameplay with higher FPS on mid-tier PCs. And CS2 uses same lighting technique. Valve just upgraded materials to PBR, means physical-based rendering, which just make models look better, and retard still cheating in this game. Anyway, now let's switch render engine from Eevee to Cycles. And this render engine uses ray tracing. That's why we can see the shadow of our object on the floor surface. It works same as Unreal Engine ray tracing, but if I switch back to Eevee, which is rasterization render engine, the shadows will disappear. That's why creators have to create shadow maps to get perfect renders, and game is created in 3D. The output we see in our screen is 2D. How that happen? Let me add a camera, and that camera, for example, is our monitor or TV screen, where we see the output of our game. Let me add a camera, and I will position it in front of our light and object. And we need to switch to camera view to understand it better. I will lock the camera to view so I can navigate camera easily. The models are 3D and they appear 2D. I mean, we can see only two dimensions properly. For example, on this side, we can't see the faces. They're completely black. But if it was ray tracing, the object will be visible to us. One important thing about rasterization is that whatever we see in our screen, for example, this camera view is our screen, and whatever inside in this screen will be rendered for us. And whatever outside this screen won't affect our scene or rendered. That's why rasterization games like GTA 5 and huge world games like Dark Souls 3 run smoothly. So that's rasterization, a technique that's been the backbone of real-time rendering for decades. With rasterization covered, we now have a complete understanding of the core rendering techniques: rasterization, ray tracing, Lumen, and path tracing. As we wrap up, let's take a moment to reflect on the journey of ray tracing and how it eventually led to the development of Lumen in Unreal Engine. Ray tracing began as a revolutionary concept to simulate light with incredible realism. It originated in offline rendering for movies and VFX, where performance wasn't as critical as achieving photorealism. Studios used ray tracing to create jaw-dropping visuals in films like Toy Story or Avatar. However, these techniques required hours or even days of rendering per frame. Then, with the advent of powerful GPUs like NVIDIA's RTX series, ray tracing became feasible for real-time applications. This opened a new chapter in gaming, allowing games like Cyberpunk 2077 and Minecraft RTX to push visual boundaries. But even then, ray tracing came with a steep performance cost, making it a luxury feature rather than a standard. Unreal Engine stepped in to bridge the gap. They introduced ray tracing support to Unreal Engine 4, but soon realized that a fully ray-traced pipeline wasn't practical for most real-time scenarios. The need for a solution that could deliver realistic lighting without the heavy computational load led to the birth of Lumen in Unreal Engine 5. In Unreal Engine 5, Lumen replaced traditional ray tracing as the default global illumination system. This shift wasn't just about performance. It was about enabling developers to create dynamic, open-world environments where light adapts in real time without needing to bake lighting or sacrifice quality. Lumen represents the next step in the evolution of rendering, combining the realism of ray tracing with the practicality of rasterization. So, while ray tracing paved the way for realistic lighting, Lumen took it to the next level by making it accessible and adaptable for modern game development. With Unreal Engine 5, developers no longer need to compromise between performance and quality, or they were jealous of NVIDIA for taking over Unreal Engine rendering pipeline. From rasterization to Lumen, we've come a long way in rendering. So, while Unreal Engine is pushing boundaries with innovations like Lumen, here's the real question. With NVIDIA doubling down on ray tracing hardware, is it even worth it when hybrid systems like Lumen make full ray tracing look kind of obsolete? Feel free to share your thoughts. I hope you understood everything I showed in my video, and if you still have any questions and doubts about any of these rendering pipelines, feel free to ask me in comment section.